there. This is Sherry Hayes with MomDelights.com, and today we are going to be going over how to do a specific McGuffey's lesson using the lesson book. So stay tuned, it's going to be a lot of fun. So here you can see I have the lesson book level one, and inside I have some pages that I printed out that are the actual pages from this book so that I can specifically show you how to use these. I have a form of these. It's not exactly the same ones, but I have a form of these pages free for download and printable for you on my blog, MomDelights.com. I will try to put the link below. And they are actually in color, whereas for this book, in order to make it affordable enough for people to purchase, I needed to use black and white on the interior. However, this form also has the dotted line, which is very helpful when children are starting out. Now, first I will show you the different parts of this lesson. As you can see, this is a words page. And in this book, I have two words pages per lesson. They face each other like this. I'll show you. Here. You see they face each other? And so that's enough for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24 possible words that you could put into this lesson. But for the purposes of this video, I'm going to show you just this one page, okay? Then the second part of the lesson is a copy work section. Also, you will note that in the word section, there is a place, a blank space below each word portion, and that is for drawings, because lots of times, I found with my little girls, they loved to write the words and then draw a little picture about it. It just helped them to remember the words, give them something important to do while their older brothers and sisters were doing something else. It's just a really nice, fun thing. And then you have something to keep showing their early work. It's a lot of fun. This is the copy work section. And here you can see we have the dotted line and we have the different gradients. And this is where you will be writing and they will be writing after you to do some copy work. And here we have a dictation page. This is where we take this copy work and we do a dictation on the copy work here. This is for a narrative drawing at the younger ages especially. They're not ready to write a narration. They need to be able to talk to you about what they've read, and then to draw something is even a little, adds a little more fun and a little more interest to the lesson. Some other things I want to point out to you are the spaces for the title, the name, the lesson number, and the date at the top. Now, I like to put these on each page if I can remember it. It kind of helps when you're going through and trying to figure out where your child is to have the actual lessons up here so that you don't have to keep flipping back and forth, if that makes sense. And also, I wanted to explain this gradient to you. Okay, so when we're learning how to write, we have like the upper, the middle, and the lava area. I call this a lava area. It's just where the tails hang down, but the letters don't go down here because this is the hot lava. That's what my little girls call it. So this just helps keep them straight when they're first writing their words. Okay, so those are the basic components of these lessons. Next, I will take, this is the primary book I will be using in this first level, okay, is the McGuffey's Pictorial Eclectic Primer. This is the original series printed by Mott Media, and they were taken from the series that was written by William Holmes McGuffey himself in the 1830s. And so I did a lot of research on that. And, you know, McGuffey was a wonderful Christian man, and he wanted Christian morality to be written in these books, but he was also a great teacher. He was teaching people how to read when he was 14, whole classes. So he was pretty good at what he did. Here in this book, we see we have just a general, like, alphabet pages These are the phonics sounds that a child would take home and use these. I have a whole curriculum for learning phonics sounds and learning how to sound out basic words, the different word patterns. You can get it for free on my blog. I will link it below. But here are the first pages for phonics. You can use these. These are kind of fun. And the illustrations really aren't that crisp because they were woodcuts and they weren't engravings. So they're kind of quaint, I guess you would say. But I think little kids still like them. You know, like this says a kid. It's supposed to be a goat kid. It's kind of ugly. But they kind of like those things, you know. Kids' illustrations are kind of interesting. So here is lesson one. One thing I want to point out when you're using the original McGuffey's readers and the subsequent ones are that when they talk about spelling, what they mean is what we call sounding out. So what you're supposed to do is you're supposed to use this list of words to help the child practice sounding out. Now this goes very well with the curriculum, the reading curriculum I have for free on my site. And what you want to do is you want to have them track from left to right and say each sound distinctly, slowly, and then put them together quickly. So basically that's what you do with this list. Then they're going to read some basic sentences. Is it an ox? Okay, basic ones. Now there's a second part to this. There's more spelling or sounding out and more reading and spelling and sounding out. Now if you have a child that's really at the beginning stages and is struggling, what you want to do is split this lesson one into three subsequent lessons. Does that make sense? And when you're using this lesson book, the lesson book, then what I would do for those three lessons is I would take these words and I would put these words in these places. Now, I know it sounds like, how can a child find a picture to draw for is? You're going to have to be a little creative. But, you know, definitely ox or my, they like the word my. And you can just be creative. And if they can't really think of anything, just say, draw mommy or draw daddy or draw the baby or draw, you know, if you have a pet or something like that. It doesn't have to be specific. It's just for fun. Okay. And just get them used to the lesson. And in this one, you know, do we go up and that type of thing. You know, it'd be amazing. You'd be amazed. My daughter could find ways to draw a picture for we. So... And, you know, three lessons worth, I mean, that's pretty good, right? And that's a lot in that, especially if you are emphasizing how to sound out and you're using the phonics lessons to help you with that. Now, in this lesson, you'll see that we don't really have a words list. We just have little sentences. So, and also some here. So you might just want to pull out some words from this, like axe or, you know, buy or so. Or go, and here in this one, this is part of the same lesson. Like I said, this is actually three parts to lesson two. You could do the same thing with this lesson as you did with the first one and split it into three parts and then take advantage of that with your lesson sheets. Now, one thing I would like to suggest is that these pictures are really interesting to talk about with your children. Get them describing what's in the picture. That's actually what they are meant for. They're meant to get the child talking. You know, reading is just an extension of talking, which is an expression in words, right? So get them talking about these pictures. Ask them questions. You know, get them talking with you. It turns out to be a really fun time with your child. It turns out, especially if you have a lot of children, when you teach them to read one-on-one, you're actually developing some relationship with them. Lesson three, they have all kinds of interesting things you can pull. You can pull words for your sheets, and it'd just be so fun. You can have so much fun with this page. You can split into two parts. You can split into as many parts as you want to and just go crazy with it. Now, when it comes to the copy work section for these pages, lots of times what you'll find is little tiny kids really don't feel comfortable writing very much, especially boys. At first, they don't have the fine motor skills necessary to do a lot of copy work. Don't angst over that. Just give them what they can handle. You know, Charlotte Mason said over and over that a little done well is better than a lot done poorly. So just give them a few words. Maybe it's one simple sentence that they can just write after you. Don't feel like you've wasted the page. It would be a real waste of the page if you gave them a whole bunch and they were so frustrated that you had an episode. That could be a waste. So just give them what they're comfortable with. And then when you do your dictation, Well, you know, give them only a few words. One or two words is plenty. Just give them what they can do. And when they do their narrative drawing, if it's a stick figure, if it's a scribble, you know, go over and around about it. Say, oh, that is so good. Oh, I just love it. Give them lots and lots of encouragement and kudos. Also, what I like to do is I like to sit down and give them a little snack or two. And so they know that whenever they're sitting down with mommy to do reading time, we have snuggles, we talk with each other, and we have a snack. Oh, that's so fun. So lesson five, we're progressing, and you can see there really aren't words lists yet. But you can pull words out from here, and you can put them into your words places, okay? Now, as we go along, the lessons will progress, and they'll get progressively longer and progressively a little bit more difficult as more words are added, but it's very gradual and very sweet. So if you are willing to go a little slower even than the book does, I think you'll have great success. Now, here we can see in this lesson, we actually have a list of words and then some sentences. So you can definitely take advantage of these sheets. This is where you will plug these in and use these, as you can see. And the copy work, and you'll be talking just all the different elements as I discussed. But when we go farther, then we have some that are just lists of words. And so that's fine. What I would do is I would show them the different patterns. Can you see the phonetic patterns here of the A words and then the it and the ins and the oys and the ads and the eds? Can you see those? You want to make sure that you really take advantage of those. Okay. So then what I would do also is I could make up on the copy work side, I can make up a few sentences that they could practice with at that point. Then that's fun too. Make them silly. Silliness really works. Okay, so we're going to go through and we're going to progress. And then towards the end of the book, as you will see, then they start having what they call, we call them two clap words. In other words, they're two syllable. Lady, holy, puny, rosy, like that. And so we will talk about having two syllables in our words. And of course they go on and they start introducing also, they're going to have the vowel, consonant, it's consonant, vowel, consonant, vowel. Or the consonant, vowel, vowel, consonant. And they're going to start, and also see the double consonant at the end. So they're going to be introducing different word patterns. So you're going to need to talk about those with your child so that they understand those. And so I wanted to show you in this lesson, this is lesson 46, right? So what is happening here is these words are becoming a little longer. At this point, the first lesson book is probably not going to be adequate. And you're going to need to go to the second lesson book. This is level 2 of the lesson book. And I will show you that. It's got the little bear in front. And the reason you want to go to this one is because it is going to have the longer areas for longer words. This is my child here. I'll show you at the beginning. And she was learning just a little bit here. Now, we use this also with the second reader. But so as you can see, it still has, and this has a dotted line in the form, the final form that I sell. It has the dotted line here so that you can easily differentiate. But yet it doesn't have the lava place for the tails of the words, but that's okay. By this time, a child is a little more comfortable writing words, so it's not as bad to do that. So you need more room in order to write these longer words. So you probably need to switch to level 2, okay? And level 2 will give you plenty of room to write the longer words. It's just careful, you know, and we're going into that. And so this book will flow into the next book. So what I was going to suggest now is that you are able to split this lesson up. Now, we've talked about the different elements. We've talked about how you have the words, you have the copy, and you know, the drawings. Then you have the copy work, and you have the dictation and the narrative drawing. Now, you don't want to overload a child and make them do all these things in one day. That means go over the lesson, write the words and draw them, do the copy work, do the dictation, do the narration drawing. That's probably overloading a child in one day. So what I do is I split it up into consecutive days, usually about 4 days. On one day, Lily will read and we'll go over the lesson. The next day, we'll do the words. The next day, the copy work. And the next day, the dictation and the narrative drawing. And that way, they have split it up and they feel much better about each day, just a little bit. You know, a little bit done over a long period of time adds up to a lot, doesn't it? So that's what I like to do. And then what I'll do is I will take an assignment sheet. I will put their name and the date, and I will put McG's, I call them McG's, and then I will put on day one. Then let me show you what I do. For this one, we'll call this Ralph. This will be Ralph's. And this will be the week of January 1, 2020, which we know is all past, but we'll do it anyway. Now, when I write McGuffey's, I write McG's, but remember, this is for a small child. So I'm going to write McGuffey here. So they can see, and they know that MC is the McGuffey, so they can kind of see that. And I'm going to probably have to help them to begin with to know what to do next. But getting them in the flow of being able to see what they're supposed to do next and check it off will be helpful. So then we're going to write the word read. And that's going to be with mom, of course, and we're going to have a checkbox. And then the next day we're going to do copy, words, and draw. So copy, words, and draw will be that. Can you see? Then on day three, we are going to do copy work, which is, you know, that whole page. On day four, we're going to do dictation. And we're going to do narration. Okay. Now, I'm going to put little check boxes here. And that way, each day, they're going to do a portion, they're going to check it off, and they're going to have great satisfaction knowing they've completed something. Does that make sense? Okay, so I hope this helps you. Also, I'm going to show you the pens that I tend to use. This is a Uniball Signo, and this is the 0.7. It's the medium. I like the micros for when I do my planner. I like the micros better because they're thinner. I mean, they have a finer line. This is really good because it's bolder and it's easier to see, especially when you're writing things in the pages. However, it's also nice to have a contrasting color. This right here is a friction pen. Now, the ink in these is kind of not the best ink, but the cool thing is that they erase so that when you make mistakes, which is what I do a lot, I can erase it. Oh, I don't know why I pulled this. This is a highlighter, but I have a correction pen. I love to use correction pens because they are very fine. And if you make a mistake, you can take that correction pen and just go over that little bit and just let it dry and go back over it. You'll see an example of that in my previous video. So I hope this helps you. I hope you like this. This is for, remember, the level one and part of level two of the lesson book, and the pictorial eclectic primer, the original series. Hope this helps you. Bye-bye.